Hi everybody, and welcome back to my BookTube channel, Books with Leo. And today, my camera battery is empty, so I'll see you in a bit. I've done a video where I recommended you guys books based on the requests that you sent into my Instagram a while ago, and I enjoyed doing that video so much that I decided to do another one. I love making these videos and giving you guys specific recommendations. So yeah, I'm really excited. Before we get into the video, I have another announcement because I'm wearing these gorgeous earrings. They were gifted to me by Evelina from Evelina Store UK, and I'm beyond excited to show them to you because they're just so beautiful. And thank you so much, Evelina, for gifting me these earrings. And if you'd like to check out her store as well, you definitely should. She's an independent business and she's a small business and she's amazing and she makes amazing earrings and jewelry as well. And yeah, you should definitely check her out. With my code Leora20, you get a discount, which is super fun. So this is not sponsored, it's just these were gifted to me. So yeah, thank you so much to Evelina, and yeah, check out her store if you want to. So without any further ado, let's finally get into the video. So I received quite a lot of requests from you guys, and I've written down some books I want to recommend in my fuzzy notebook. It is so soft, I just want to like pet it all day long. Okay, so I've received many requests again. So one of the first requests I see on here is a book with a fat person as the main character, and I have a few for this one actually. So this is the one I most recently read. This is Spoiler Alert by Olivia Dade. I think a lot of you have probably already heard of this if you watch my other videos as well. This is a romance with a fat protagonist, and her name's April. She's amazing. She's so passionate. She's a fanfic writer, and she loves this one show in particular, and she does a cosplay of a character in that show, and her cosplay goes viral, which is super cool. But she gets a lot of backlash as well because of her body type, which is just really not what she wanted, of course. And then the actor that plays one of the characters on that super big fantasy show asks her out on a date to sort of show all the bullies like she's beautiful the way she is. And yeah, a romance blossoms from there. And he's also a fanfiction writer, and they've been friends online for years, but they don't know that of each other. So that's a fun element as well. I think if you love fandom in general, like fandom and being fan of things, and you've been in fandoms and you love romance and fluffiness and humor in books, then this is definitely the read for you. And it is very body positive as well. She deals with like struggles in society, of course, but still she herself does love herself and her body, which is really important to see in fiction, I think. And another one that I haven't read but is very high on my list is One to Watch by Kate Stayman London. I've heard some mixed reviews on this one. There's some people saying that they didn't like the fat rap in this book, but there's other people that absolutely love it and adore it. So there's definitely mixed opinions on this one, so be aware of that going in. You can always check some reviews on Goodreads if you want to know exactly what like the criticisms and the appraisals for this novel were. As far as I know, this is about Bia, who's a stylish plus size fashion blogger, and she has amazing friends and amazing family, but she's not had a relationship in a while. So she goes in and participates in this sort of bachelorette-esque dating show, and this book follows her in the dating show. That's all I know. It's supposedly really funny and it has a lot of banter, and the romance is supposed to be amazing. And I've heard from people that this book is super diverse as well, so I love books that are about reality TV, so that's especially why this one is really high on my TBR as well. But yeah, I've had some mixed reviews, so that has made me doubt a little bit, but yeah, I'll definitely want to check it out. Then I got a request for a wholesome read, and wholesome reads are some of my favorite reads because I love books that just make you feel good. Those are some of my favorite books because I just want to be soothed sometimes. I just want to be calmed down by a book. I just want to feel warm and safe and happy. So I've got you. So the first feel good wholesome book I want to recommend is Howl's Moving Castle by Deanna Wynne Jones. This is a favorite of mine, and I've recently got on the paperback actually because I've listened to this on audiobook mostly, because I used to have a copy but I lost it. Very sad story. Yeah, so I'm really happy to have a copy again, and it is one of those lovely floppy paperbacks, and I'm very happy about it. Leonie gifted this to me. Thank you, Leonie. This book is about Sophie, and she works in a hat shop, and she gets a curse on her, and then she has to fix the curse. And in order to fix the curse, she has to go to Howl, and Howl lives in a moving castle, and he's a wizard, and he supposedly eats girls' hearts, and it's like, ooh. Oh no. And then she sort of has a deal with a demon that lives in Howl's Moving Castle in order to help her break the curse. That's all you need to know going in. The Studio Ghibli movie is also absolutely amazing. I love it. Like, there's so many beautiful frames in it, and I can really recommend the audiobook for this one as well because it has like some orchestra bits in between, and that really makes for an amazing atmosphere in the book. So yeah, this is one of my favorite feel-good books, and I can't wait to read it again very, very soon now that I have a physical copy again. Another one I'd like to recommend in this category is Heretics Anonymous by Katie Henry. This is a book I have not talked about a lot on this channel because I've read it quite a while ago, but this is definitely a great read for when you want something wholesome and funny that still touches on some important topics, so I would highly recommend this. This is about a guy who goes to a very religious school, if I remember correctly, but he's an atheist, and along the way being on this school, he learns a lot of different things about different religions and different views on the world and about feminism and about many different things, and it's just so funny. It has amazing comic relief, and at the same time it's very nice to see all these different sort of standpoints on religion and views on the world and what really matters. And yeah, this is just a really fun feel-good book that still touches on some more important and serious topics than the other one I just recommended. Books with found family elements. Okay, I've got some. Okay, so let's start off with a book that I've mentioned loads of times on this channel, and that is The Black Veins by Asia Monet. You can see my copy's kind of battered. It looks like it's been through something, and it has been, because I took this book everywhere during last summer. I was enjoying it so much. I got a second copy as well of the new cover. Asia sent it to me. Thank you so much, Asia. This is one of my favorite urban fantasy books. It's just so wholesome and full of banter, and it just makes me so happy, and it has amazing found family as well. This is about Blythe, and she's one of the seven guardians, and guardians are basically magicians, and they're powerful enough to like do anything. They're really, really powerful, and they need to come together to save her parents because they've been kidnapped by this evil magician government. That's basically the premise of the book. And along the way, she meets the other magicians who are all very chaotic teenagers with different struggles and things they go through. And they form this amazing group that goes on a magical road trip to save her family. And it's just so much fun. The banter is amazing. The friendships are amazing. And yeah, if you're looking for some books with great found family elements, I would highly, highly, highly recommend this one. I've talked about that book so many times on my channel that I thought I should add a more new read to this recommendation list as well, and that is The Good Luck Girls by Charlotte Nicole Davis. This is also a fantasy book, and this also has some amazing found family elements and also a road trip. This is about girls who are in a brothel, and one of them accidentally kills a man, and then they escape and they go on this journey across their country to sort of get rid of their marks, because they have a magical mark on their face that shows that they came from that brothel and they cannot sort of escape their faith and ever truly be free unless the mark gets removed. Along the way, they meet many amazing people that are like in magical rebellions that have gone through stuff themselves, and this book is really, really high on found family, sisterhood. They sort of turn into rebels and thieves themselves, so it's got some of those elements as well. There's a queer relationship with some of the side characters. There's romance in it, not a lot, but like a little bit. And the world in this fantasy is full of ghosts and like ghost lore, which is really cool because I hadn't seen that a lot before in fantasy. So this is definitely a book I would also recommend for that request. This person would like a mystery or murder book that is also very funny. Okay, I have the perfect book for you, but I haven't read it yet myself, but other people say that it's very funny, so let's hope they're right. And that book is The Thursday Murder Club by Richard Osman. I've just heard that this book is hilarious, and it's also a murder mystery in a sense. So let me read the back to you. In a peaceful retirement village, four unlikely friends meet up once a week to investigate unsolved murders. But when a brutal killing takes place on their very doorstep, the Thursday Murder Club find themselves in the middle of their first live case. Can our unorthodox but brilliant gang catch the killer before it's too late? So this supposedly has amazing British humour. I feel like I'm saying the word supposedly a lot in this video, I'm not sure why. Supposedly. This is very funny, and I love that it's about people in a retirement home, because you don't read about characters of that age a lot. All the characters are very old. I think they're like all in their 70s or 80s, which is just really cool. You don't see that a lot. And I've read some books before about a guy in a retirement home, and those books were also very funny, so I hope to take the same sort of atmosphere into these books. And yeah, a group of people solving murders always sounds good to me, so I cannot wait to dive into this one, and I think it's perfect for this request as well. Although I'll let you know when I've read it, I'll update you on my thoughts on it. Okay, someone said queer boarding schools. You guys are always requesting the same things. That's okay though, it's okay. And somebody else says, a group of pretentious students. Please, I just want to feel like the secret history made me feel. Okay, I've got some recs for you. Although you might have heard of them already, but we'll see. So firstly, of course, I'm coming out back again with Plain But Heroines by Emily M. Denforth. It's full of queer girls, and it is also a boarding school, and it is sort of, it has some of the secret history vibes, not all of them. This is sort of like truly devious, so like two timelines, a mystery and deaths in one of the timeline, and then sort of new people coming to the boarding school in the other timeline. Only in this book it's actresses from Hollywood that are filming a sort of movie about the things that happened in 1902, the murders and deaths that happened in 1902, not like murders but like mysterious deaths. And yeah, it's full of queer girls. It is, the atmosphere is amazing. I've just finished it. It took me a while. It's pretty slow. It's like not a lot happens and the plot kind of fizzled out towards the end in my opinion, but still the atmosphere was so good. And yeah, this is definitely a dark academia read you should not miss out on if you're interested in this type of story. Just to switch things up, because I've talked about playing bad heroines in literally every video, I know, don't come for me. I'm sorry. I'm recommending Bunny by Mona Awad. Have not read it. But yeah, it just seems really great for this request because Bunny is about a group of students, and a lot of people say that if you love The Secret History, you would also love this book, so that's why I'm recommending it. Okay, so it says on the back, Samantha Heather Mackey couldn't be more of an outsider in her small, highly selective MFA program at an elite New England university. A scholarship student who prefers the company of her dark imagination to that of most people, she's utterly repelled by the rest of her fiction writing cohort. A clique of unbearably twee rich girls who call each other Bunny and seem to move and speak as one. But everything changes when Samantha receives an invitation to the Bunny's fabled smut cellar and finds herself inexplicably drawn to their front door, ditching her only friend in the process. Well, you can kind of see the gist of this story. I think this is going to be such a cool read and I cannot wait to read it myself, but it also seems very fitting for this request, so that is why I'm pulling it up. Okay, I think those were plenty of requests and plenty of recommendations for today. I really hope you enjoyed this video and you got some great recs out of it. Definitely let me know if you've read any of these books and if you've enjoyed them. And I'll see you guys in my next video. And yeah, if you want to see a part 3 of me recommending you books based on your specific requests, then let me know. Bye!